I also, on this momentous day, have the privilege, the absolute privilege, of inviting someone else up. I would like to invite up our new staff member, Paul Richards, and his wife Karen is with him too. Karen, come on up too. Give him a hand. Paul is coming on as ministry associate, and he's working part-time for now. Some of you have gotten to know him over the past year. We're really grateful for you guys in our church. Paul is full of faith and wisdom and hope, and we're going to be really blessed by his ministry in our congregation. He's going to start with some pastoral care and some life groups as he continues with his job. Next week, we will be praying for him and commissioning him, so be sure to be here for that. And then in a couple weeks, he's going to preach to us, so be sure to be there to hear his heart. Let me let you share.
Thank you, Hannah. I'm just full of thankfulness this morning. Thankful to God. God is so good. And thank you, Jenna, too, for your powerful testimony of your personal relationship with Jesus. Just God's goodness and mercy will chase after you all the days of your life. Speak that over you today, Jenna. And you might be sitting there, too, wondering, wait a second, I've met Paul, and isn't he an elementary school teacher? Now this, like, what is going on? I see Joanna there really wondering that, because I work with her. So yes, it's true. I have been and still will be an elementary school teacher part-time, and the current plan is to do that part-time and come on staff part-time, and we'll see where the Spirit leads. I also wanted to thank and acknowledge my lovely wife, Karen. I love you, and you are such a support and encouragement to me in everything, and it's so much fun to be married to you. It's just a joy. Thanks for that. And I'm also very thankful for my family, too. A couple of family members came out today, so that's really nice to have them. I'm thankful for the leadership of the church, and I'm thankful for you, the people, because the church is people. And I see my role here as one of service. I've been called to serve you and to come alongside you, to listen to you and to pray with you and to encourage you and to pray for you and to offer guidance and teaching. And I'd like to speak the words of Jeremiah 29:11 over our church this morning. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Amen.